quickly escalating from slightly erratic, the suspected drink driver is barreling through a residential area at 50 miles an hour.
Straight through red 8, yeah, temporarily firing.
Flying through reds, they seem hell-bent on escaping the law. On wet roads, stopping distances are thought to double.
Off one, we're now doing 4-0 and a 3-0. Increasing to 5-0.
But with the winter rain hammering down, this driver continues putting pedal to the metal. Thankfully, at 3:30 in the morning, the roads are empty as the driver tears through streets at well over 70 miles per hour. In the suburbs, packed with playing fields and alleyways, it's a decamper's dream.
We are now at Hillistic Road, generally back towards Arnold, I think.
Other units are aiming to get ahead with a stinger.
0-0-6-3-9, we are Arnold with stinger. We'll look for stinger side.
And dog handler Mark is also trying to catch up, along with his trusty canine, Morse.
Continuing now to Birchfield Road. Speed is 6.5.
However, time could be running out.
Wrong side of the road, medium risk, still no other road users or pedestrians.
The lead car is still locked on target.
Continuing on Birchfield Road, speed is now 4.0.
But the golf driver's reaching the end of the road.
I know he's gone over the tank traps, stand by.
With interceptors braced for a decamp, the dicey driver careers over a pavement at full pelt.
On to, I think this is Killistic Road again. It is Killistic Road. We're doing loot.
Circling past the playing fields for a second time, the suspected drink driver could still be looking for somewhere to bail out.
Remains Killistic Road, speed is 5-0. Where is the next available unit, please?
Wages Crossing Road coming towards you now.
We're still on the same loop. We're on Birchfield Road again now. CRA, medium.
Heading for the end of the road, take two.
It's going to be left. Stand by. Got running.
The driver decides to take his chances on foot, but the interceptors are hot on his heels.
We've got a vehicle failing to stop.
In Arnold, the interceptors are in pursuit of a suspected drink driver who's hitting high speeds and taking big risks on wet winter roads.
I know he's gone over the tank traps. Stand by.
After leading cops on a loop of the estate,
he's going to be left.
The driver hits the brakes.
Stand by.
And is on his toes with an officer close behind. As the driver makes a break for it, so does one of the three passengers, who quickly sees sense and returns. Leaving Rich Elliott alone and taser drawn to deal with the three passengers, two of which are becoming aggressive.
Get off of you!
Right, the pair of you, so all three of you are being detained, right? Calm it down.
Stop.
What's that? Right, stay there. You're
going to taser that?
Yeah, I'm going to taser you if you couldn't be aggressive, yeah.
Faced with the prospect of 50,000 volts, the passengers are keeping their distance, but still making threats.
Yeah, I've got three lads here, all from the car. Just need units to meet.
What's smashing the head?
You're going to smash my head, aren't you?
That's all right. Real.
Obviously, I just need to check that the car's legit.
Just stop.
All right.
That is not our problem.
All right.
My dad's funeral.
Yeah, I appreciate that. But saying you're going to smash my head is not going to help the situation, is it?
No, because it's my dad's funeral.
Right.
I get
why you might be upset.
Finally, the cavalry arrives.
If you don't want to stop, that's not our problem. We're telling him Yeah. Slow down.
Fine.
Stop.
Fine.
Pull over.
Yeah, but they've never put me in aggressive with me. I didn't know he's judging.
I'm sorry.
Right.
I'm sorry.
Fine. Right. Sorted. Right. We'll get to the bottom of it, won't we?
One way of getting to the bottom of it will be to question the driver, and a suspect has been chased deep into the estate.
Stay there. Need a unit to me. I've got one detained. Stay there. Put your hands on the floor. Put your hands. Keep your hands where I can see them.
To ensure the suspect doesn't get the chance to make another run for it, the officer calls for backup. But after the foot chase through dark alleyways, he's lost.
I'm on a footpath behind some houses.
The lone interceptor uses an app to guide in backup.
My what three words are adding, pass.
What three words is an app often used by the emergency services to pinpoint locations. Every 3 metres squared in the world is identified by a unique combination of three words, meaning help in the form of Mark, Paul and Chalky is on hand in no time.
Hi. What's your name, pal? It's done now, ain't it? Is that you? Is it you or not?
You're over telling the car, it's not me.
I don't know.
Well, I'm not. I'll just bet someone.
Well, yeah, because he'll follow you from the driver's seat, mate.
There you go.
OK, sort it out of custody then, won't we?
With the suspected driver detained, the passengers are free to go. But back at the car, once again, aggression levels are rising. One of the raging passengers sees red and is heading for the cameraman.
Oh, cameraman! Hey! Hey!
Kicking off, he's refusing to go down without a fight.
Bit of a melee.
Stay there!
Blonde, find your back.
He's arrested for drunken disorderly behaviour.
Do this bit nicely, shall we?
Gladly do it.
It's been an eventful night shift for Rich, having handled the pursuit and an angry car full.
Two were quite hostile. Fortunately, I had a taser, so I drew it and red-dotted them. I'm not going to have a fight with three lads on my own. It's not going to end well, quite frankly. Well, I've been told that the driver's well in drink. The speeds they were doing in residential areas is just dangerous through and through. But fortunately, there have been no injuries, and we've brought it to a successful and safe resolution.
The lad nicked in the alleyway was convicted of dangerous driving and failing to provide a specimen, as well as driving without a valid licence or insurance. He got 9 months behind bars and was banned from driving for 24 months. The passenger who kicked off was ordered to pay a fixed penalty notice for drunk and disorderly behaviour. It's fair to say an interceptor can never drop their guard. No two jobs are the same, and not all suspects put their bad behaviour on show from the get-go.
It's not unusual that you might meet, you know, Mr. Nice Guy 1 second who becomes Mr. Nasty in sort of a split second. If people are fuelled by alcohol or drugs, then they become sort of unpredictable by definition, really. Mood swings. One moment compliant, one moment not. Sometimes it's trying to sort of reason with the unreasonable.
On patrol in the unmarked Volvo are Rob and the Sarge, Ian.
Yeah, it's in towards the city, heading towards QMC by the looks of it.
There are reports of another suspected drink driver.
Got somebody who's been seen leaving the pub a little worse for wear. He's got into a red Audi. We've now got a police officer behind it on the ring road. So we're just going to try and catch up with it.
While Rob puts his foot down, the suspect is being tailed by a plain car.
I'm out London for cover. Continues over Dunkirk.
Zulu 5, just coming past QMC now.
Rugby player Ian has nearly two decades' experience as an interceptor, and knowing that the driver could be over the limit, the last thing he wants is a pursuit.
Approaching the next junction with the X453.
To kick the driver's journey into touch, the plan is to wrap the Audi in a three-car box.
Approaching the underpass where it splits off towards Clifton.
A second unit gets behind the red Audi.
Currently a lane two.
Closely followed by Rob and Ian.
Zulu 5, we're just coming up behind you, Clifton Boulevard. Got your third T-pack in the stick now, we're at the back.
With everyone in position, the suspected drink driver navigates off the main road.
Close up.
And the team break cover.
As we approach the junction with A60, we'll go for it then. Strike.
Car boxed, zero contact.
Easy, mate.
A flawless finish.
We stopped you because you've got some drink. Possibly drink driving, is that correct?
No.
OK. How much have you actually had to drink?
I've had a couple.
Yeah? What, beer, lagers or...?
Yeah, a couple of lagers, yeah.
The cool-headed driver admits he's just left the pub. So, to clear the road, the team move round the corner for a breathalyser.
I have to warn you, there is an offence to fail or refuse to provide me with a specimen under these circumstances. Do you understand?
Yes.
Yeah, good.
This stops going like clockwork, as the compliant driver is only too happy to do a breath test.
Keep going, lovely, thank you. That's it, stop. So as you can see, it's come up with a fail, with a result of 55, the limit is 35. OK, so you're now under arrest on suspicion of driving whilst over the prescribed limit.
Having failed the roadside breath test, the driver will be taken to the Nick to give an evidential specimen of breath.
It's not caused us any trouble, having only just left the pub. He might still be going up, so he might blow at a higher rate when we get him to the custody suite. We'll just have to find out.
So far, this stop has been plain sailing. But once they reach custody...
What are you looking for? Are you putting drugs on me? Is that what you... doing you?
It's a different story.
You're nailing me, aren't you? No. That's what you're doing, you're trying to nail me!
Stop nailing me.
You're trying to nail me.
It's all on camera, you're being searched.
Jesus. Oh, think you're strong, dude. Do you think you're strong? What have you put on me?
The search is all clear.
Like you say, guys, I'm not going anywhere.
With peace somewhat restored, Ian is ready to take the driver for his breath test. But there's another problem.
It's toilet or after that, mate? Well, I can't go before.
Ian can't let the driver go to the toilet until after he's completed the breath test. Because if the suspect doesn't give a specimen of breath, that first sample of urine could be golden evidence, which can be tested for alcohol levels.
Mind if I piss on the floor then?
Well, I can't stop you wetting yourself, but I would prefer if you didn't.
That's what it might come to. I'm a 50-year-old bloke, yeah?
Despite Ian's preference...
Oh, dear.
..the suspect urinates in the cell.
Have you seen this piss all over the floor, mate? Look.
Don't flick that at me.
Right,
pack it in!
Yeah?
Stop.
Piss all over the floor.
Pack it in.
Piss.
Right.
Piss all over the floor.
Stupid. Come out the way.
Piss all over the floor. Yeah?
Last chance. Calm down. Now stand up.
Well.
Stand up and take a breath.
I've asked for assistance and you've just gone like that.
I didn't.
You just said, like, no. You're not having no assistance.
At what point did I say that to you? I said you have to wait a couple of minutes while we do the test. And you decided to wet yourself.
You're going to stay to me.
Yeah, we're going to swap them trousers in a minute. We can't do
that. Oh, yeah, that's brilliant. Are you going to put them on the
line as well.
After receiving some fresh clothes courtesy of custody, it's finally time for the evidential breath test.
We've managed to get this chap to calm down a little bit now. He's said so far he's going to go through with the intox procedure. We've got him in the intox room now, and hopefully we'll get a sample.
I warn you that failure to provide either of these specimens will render you liable to prosecution. Do you agree to provide two specimens of breath for analysis?
I want a blood test.
Once again, the suspected drink driver is not playing ball.
Listen to
me. I want blood.
Listen to me.
Because I know how good I am.
The offer is, for a breath test, we do not offer
blood. Blood.
Unless specific circumstances arise and you do not meet that criteria at this stage.
Blood samples can be taken if there's a reason to believe someone cannot do the breath test for medical reasons.
I don't want to breathe into, other people's breath. I want blood.
OK. So are there any medical reasons why you cannot or should not provide two specimens of breath?
Yeah, I don't... I know for a fact I can't breathe that hard.
There are specific criteria to meet for you to have a blood sample. You cannot simply request it. So unless you're going to provide two specimens of breath, I'll take that as a refusal and we'll go back to the custody sergeant.
So wrong.
Fantastic. Do you want to stand up for me then, please?
Failing to provide a sample can carry a maximum sentence of 6 months imprisonment, a driving ban, or an unlimited fine.
But he's probably blowing outside.
None at all. In fact, he kept blowing after I told him to stop.
Well, that's good evidence, isn't it?
He's trying every trick in the book at the moment, just stalling for time. Trying to eke it out, trying to make complaints.
I've had 15, well, at least 12 cop cars around me, yeah. I don't know why. What was that all about?
This process has been going on for many, many years, and everybody's tried to find a loophole, and there just isn't one. The law is quite clear.
For failing to provide a specimen, the driver was banned from the roads for 12 months and had to pay a total of £199 in fines and costs.
9 times out of 10, you know, you'll get somebody who starts off like this individual, absolutely calm, quite placid, absolutely fine. 9 times out of 10, they'll remain like that through your entire encounter with them. But this guy's just a reminder that not everyone stays calm. Never drop your guard with people.
Coming up...
Hey, you OK, guys?
Yeah, yes, thank you.
Gav and Macca interrupt a night ride in Newark.
I'd appreciate some honesty.
Sorry, sir.
Because you're acting really nervous.
And...
I think it's going to go off-road again.
The Interceptors go off-road to tackle an illegal rider. Rapid, nimble,
vehicle still failing to stop, currently medium risk,
able to mount pavements and go where cars can't follow. Few are more dangerous than a menace on a motorbike.
We've got a duty of care to the rider because of the risk that comes with pursuing a motorbike to the rider. They'll hedge the bets that they'll be able to fail to stop, will abort, but criminals can't be under the illusion that if they ride a bike they'll get away with things, because they won't. We will go after them and we will stop them.
In a northerly suburb of Nottingham, dog handler Jen Else is blue lighting to a job when a rider on a high-powered bike up ahead wrongly thinks the lights and sirens are for him and floors it, overtaking traffic, failing to stop at 70 and charging the wrong way over a roundabout towards oncoming cars. The reckless rider makes a potentially lethal mistake. As he he tries to overtake and crashes into a car turning right. The rider is sent flying down the road along with his bike. A collision at such high speeds could be catastrophic. But miraculously, the walking wounded suspect is fleeing the scene. News of the crash travels fast.
Left together now.
Firearms cops Lisa and Paul are one of a number of units responding.
We're just going to get there, check that the status of the member of the public who's been hit, I would think, and try and find the slab that's made off. It'll be just here, just off. The bike's all the way down there.
That's what I mean.
Right. Yeah. That took you by surprise, didn't it? You got anyone? You got any kids in or anything?
No.
The driver appears to be okay, but shaken by the crash.
If you got probably a bit of shock, and you might get a pain later on or something like that, I would
no,
think.
That way.
I don't even know.
That way or that yeah, way? Not that way.
As long as you've got somebody with you at home, because you never know when a bit of shock might kick in. All right.
Thankfully, the innocent member of the public doesn't seem to have been seriously injured. But the damage to his car clearly shows the force of the impact.
Can't believe how far down the motorbike's gone.
Scattered down the road are the rider's helmet, a shoe, and the bike, which has scored the pavement before coming to a stop.
When we get riders of motorbikes that fail to stop, they ride terrible, you know, they ride really fast. They weave in and out of vehicles, and they don't really see the dangers ahead of them because they're going too fast for their own ability. And if, as you can see, it's a long way down there.
After the crash, the rider was seen jumping a fence into gardens. So the team have contained the area while they search for the suspect.
We don't believe the rider of the bike's got any major injuries to worry about, but it is concerning when they go and we don't know where they are. It's always surprise. Oh, they've got him. Oh, that's fab. So the update we've just had over the air is that another couple of AFOs, Dan and Rob, have found him. He's missing a trainer and covered in blood, but he's conscious breathing. So that's positive, and positive that we found him.
Recent figures show around 32% of motorcycle accidents result in riders sustaining serious injuries. Having witnessed this accident firsthand, Jen is thankful the rider hasn't become another statistic.
As I've come up this road, it's a typical, got my blue lights on, he thinks that I'm after him, and he's just clipped the car. The bike's rolled over, and I was just fearing the worst, to be honest. And we've since found out the bike's stolen, been stolen a year, riding around on false plates. And no insurance, and he's got no license either, so that's why he was running. But for me, he's lucky to be alive, to be honest. That could have ended very differently.
The rider escaped without serious injuries. He's currently awaiting a charging decision for dangerous driving, driving without a valid license or insurance, failing to stop for the police, and theft of a motor vehicle. No further action was taken for the suspected false plates. Knowing the danger illegal riders are prepared to put not only themselves in, but everyone else on the road, the interceptors are more determined than ever to catch them. Out and about in the northwest of the county are Matt and Lee from the knife crime team. Although this shift, it's not weapons on the menu.
You've got to let it stop. It's not very big, but...
It's rounding up an off-road biker who is refusing to stop.
There is currently 6-5 on back lane, it's leading west. It's offside of Key Left Bollard, in fact, it's the correct side of the road.
Pursuit authorised, the runaways rallying around corners and running red lights at crossroads.
Yeah, temporarily high risk on through a red ATS.
Trying to lose the interceptors. One thing the rider isn't banking on is he's caught the attention of the whole team.
We're Old Mill Lane now. Where's best for us to go?
Plotting up nearby are Johnny and Mozza.
Just getting a stinger out in case he comes down this way. Stinger's been authorised, so we're going to get one out and sit with it on the lap just in case.
And travelling in from across town to tighten the net are Chantelle and Dean.
That's one more. Left,
left, one lane. Nice going right into where the old Nick White would have.
Sure enough, with Matt and Lee in pursuit, the rider pulls the textbook move.
Danny, stop. Don't regret them. Technically lost Quarry Hill. He'll come out on Vale Road. I can't follow him due to a metal barrier.
The biker may be off-road, but he's far from off the radar.
If he does come out at Pleasley, though, where would it come out? I don't think it'd go straight.
Roundabout to Pleasley, and either do back into Mansfield or right towards Shardwell.
Devil, I'm going to go Shardwell.
Adrenaline junkie Chantel's dream set of two wheels would be the supercharged Kawasaki Ninja H2R. But today, she'll settle for intercepting this off-roader. Chantelle and Dean comb the country roads.
Hey up, stand by.
Is that it?
An H outside.
Yeah.
They picked up the rider for a second time.
We're behind it. It's a common lane back towards Mansfield.
True to form, the rider is hitting high speeds to escape.
Into
lane 0 in a
6-0.
He's going left, into industrial estate, out down lane.
1-3, we're ahead.
Right, Church Lane, it's come off the main drag.
Leading them to another dead end.
I think it's going to go off-road again.
He's up to old tricks with disappearing axe number 2.
The initial one I think you picked up.
So he's gone down there.
With a dog handler on scene, Dean and Chantelle go into the fields to look for the rider. No chance for a disappearing hat trick. They find the rider hiding in the bushes.
Behind your back, then.
Victory for the knife crime team.
1-2.
Boom.
Confirm 1-2.
You're under arrest. Phone and stop the police.
Right, no problem.
Don't say anything. We have friends. You know, my questions.
Something
actually trying to call.
The catch of the day doesn't have a licence or insurance either.
Jump in there.
Knowing the next stop is custody, he's been left wondering where it all went wrong.
I'm getting caught on motocross bikes. Understand what's happened.
Thanks to the interceptor's determination, the rider was convicted of failing to stop and driving without a valid licence or insurance. He received a 12-month suspended prison sentence, 120 hours of unpaid work, and was disqualified from driving for 2 years. To top it off, his bike was scrapped. The Rhodes crime team's bread and butter is stopping suspects on the move. And there's more than one way to get the job done. From full-blown operations...
Vehicle stopped. No damage.
Engine off.
To reacting to hits on the ANPR network.
Oh, maybe obsession with an axe.
And you just can't beat...
That scrapper.
A good old bit of interceptor intuition.
I knew he looked dodgy.
It was a good one, that.
Macca and Gav are in Newark.
See him.
Just one look at a passing green polo and they're on its bumper. Gav runs the car through the police computer.
Drugs information, Eastleigh.
Stop him.
Yeah.
With another unit already on hand, Macca lights up the polo.
Get out, mate.
And Gav gets straight to the point.
Hey, you okay, guys?
Yeah, yeah. Yes, thank you.
I'm going to ask you straight up, mate. Are you carrying anything here that shouldn't be in there?
No.
So, no. Hang on, I'd appreciate
some honesty. Sorry, sir.
Because you're acting really nervous, okay? And I've just done a quick check on the car, just in that time before I stopped you, and there's some information around you maybe involved in drugs.
Right,
okay. So I'm going to ask you now, if you've got some personal use, we can sort it out at the roadside. But you are going to get a search and misuse of drugs act, so it's a good time just to tell me if you're carrying anything. You're not. Okay.
Before joining Rhodes Crime, Gav spent years on the beat with the knife crime team, hunting down those carrying weapons and drugs.
Demeanor's very nervous, mate. Both of them. Keep your hand where I can see it, please, mate. Yeah.
And alarm bells are ringing about this twitchy twosome.
What you been to Newark for?
I'm just with my friend coming along.
OK, and how long have you been here for, then?
I'll say about 40 minutes.
OK, just come to Newark for 40 minutes?
Yeah.
All right, step out, buddy. Keep your hand where I can see it, mate.
Yeah.
It's great to see that, Tom.
The cops aren't buying it's a swift night trip to Newark, so with the help of fellow interceptor Nick, the driver, passenger and polo are searched.
Turn around first, buddy.
Yeah, sure.
You want to tell me what this is in the footwell of the car?
No, I've just been sitting in the car.
Right. Nick. Right, at the minute, I suspect this is a Class A drug, so you're under arrest on suspicion of possessing a Class A drug with intent to supply. You don't have to say anything that may harm your defence if you don't answer some questions, something which later line in court, and anything you do say may be given evidence. That was in the footwell of the car where you were sat.
Okay. I've just been
and also on suspicion of possessing a bladed article.
I bought that today.
Remember, you're under caution and this camera is filming.
Yeah.
Within 5 minutes of stopping the motor, the interceptors have found a package of suspected cocaine and two knives. But the polo is the gift that keeps on giving.
A baton?
Yeah.
Baton as well.
Right, as it stands, right, it's Class A Peewits.
Yeah.
It's bladed article times two.
Yeah.
And off-wet times one, because it's an extendable baton.
Yeah.
Has he got anything on him?
It's just the scales.
Scales. We'll finish that search. I'll come back to you.
There's more. Mac has found a large wad of cash. And he's yet to search the boot.
Whose bags are this?
Nothing to do with me, sir.
That's had a load of cannabis. He just sold it.
Yeah.
That's what all the cash is for.
Yeah. We'll seize that.
So that box has got a Ziploc bag in it, like a vacuum pack bag, which has obviously been full of cannabis. It's empty now, but it stinks. So I'm guessing they've just sold all the cannabis, which is why they've got all the cash in the wallet. So, yeah, two knives, a baton, drugs, cash. Decent result.
Keen to gather as much evidence as possible, once the suspects are dropped off at custody, Macca and Gav execute a warrant at an address linked to the driver and seize a safe, as well as another interesting find.
It's one of these magnetic boxes here, which are common for drug dealers. What they do is put the drugs inside, secure it with the clips. It's magnetic, stick it underneath the car, and often you'll look underneath the car and you'll find one of these full of drugs or cash.
Both items are seized for the investigation. The safe was cracked open but found to be empty. However, both the driver and passenger have been released under investigation for dealing Class A drugs and possession of an offensive weapon. Still to come.
Oh, that's it, oh, though. That's one there.
A disqualified driver is in denial.
You self driving? Yeah,
no,
okay.
No, I'm not. What?
So, are you driving that car?
When?
Just now.
No. So,
halfway through a 12-hour day shift on Lisa and Rich.
I've got a feeling I'm going to drink this. It's going to go everywhere.
Wait till I'm going over the bumps and yeah, real, you know, tea experience.
The danger thing.
Off-duty thrill-seeker Rich is a keen adventure racer. In a previous life, he was an intelligence analyst. And now, with 14 years on the force...
Yes, it's heading towards that way.
..he's an expert at keeping tabs on cloned cars.
I'm just having an activation on an ANPR camera of a vehicle that's believed to be on cloned plates. So we're just going to put ourselves in the area and see if we can pick it up.
The black Golf on suspected cloned plates has already hit two ANPR cameras.
I'm going to go shield-wise towards there.
Typically, false plates are often used to hide the identity of a stolen car or a dodgy driver.
An H were not far down.
As a third camera hit comes in, there's no doubt the motor is still on the road.
Yeah, kill him now. Hopefully it'll be at the 610 junction.
Nearing the Black Golf's last known location, the interceptor's view is blocked by a lorry.
Ah. I think it may have gone straight up, mate. I just saw a Golf, I think, go straight up.
Lisa tries to get a line of sight.
NH, we might have just caught sight of it going across the 610, continuing in towards Broxton. It's not confirmed, though.
Straight on?
Yeah, go straight on, I'm sure. Might even see it.
Reaching the busy crossroads...
Yeah, go.
There's no sign of the Golf.
And there's a million ways it could turn off already.
The trail's gone cold.
It's not pinged anything since.
If the suspected cloned car isn't pinging cameras, chances are it's been parked up somewhere nearby.
Oh, what's this?
No.
Lisa and Rich check each and every turn.
Oh, that's it,
That's it.
That's one there.
Until they clap eyes on it.
We're with this Golf Woodfield Road.
The engine is still running and a couple are lingering nearby.
Excuse me. Excuse me. Hey, mate. Is that your car?
Getting
coat out of it. Sorry?
Getting stuff out of it.
Coats. You're getting your coat out of it? You're driving? Yeah, OK.
No, I'm not. What?
I think you were driving it. I've seen the image of the driver.
Yeah, I was driving.
Were you driving that car?
When?
Just now.
No.
So that car's just got there, hasn't it?
No, I wasn't driving the car.
So you've got your coat out of it?
Why are you lying?
You just see me up in the back door.
Yeah.
Someone is selling porkies, and it's not Rich.
Righto.
Have you just seen me drive that car?
I haven't seen nothing.
No, but I've seen an ANPR image of a female driving the car.
You just said that you've just seen me driving the car.
I've seen an ANPR image of a female driving that car.
So you've seen a video.
NH, we've got a couple detained here at the shop, so we're just trying to get to the bottom of it. They're denying driving it.
Rich applies a little more pressure.
Just keep your hands out of your pockets, folks. What we're going to do is going to give you a quick search. In a minute, I suspect that car might be stolen, OK?
Stolen?
Yeah. Stolen? Are you mad?
That's the reason why.
Never, ever do. Come on, mate.
That is not a stolen car.
OK, well, how do you know that, then? And if you know a bit more about it, then tell me.
Yeah, all right, then. Yeah. I was the driver, and it's not a stolen car.
Right. OK. Is it on false plates? Is it on false plates?
I've just bought the car.
You've just bought it?
I've literally bought the car.
Okay.
I bought it from...
The driver admits she recently bought the car for 500 quid. Right. And while we're spilling the beans...
Have you got a licence?
No, I've got a written one.
That's not quite the whole truth either.
Right, so you're disqualified until April.
Why was that?
Yeah, it's on our database, so it's on the DL database. So, okay, so you shouldn't be driving.
Well, I thought it, thought it was up.
No, come on, not until April next year.
She's banned from driving for another 14 months.
Also, the car's not on the right plates. It's on, yeah, the clone plates. So, which I think if you were straight with me, you'd say
from
no. Because you're driving whilst disqualified without a licence, okay, which is probably why it's on false plates, to avoid having to go through the official channels and get all your documentation sorted.
All roads lead to the same outcome. The interceptors will be taking the car off her hands. Anne reporting her for driving whilst disqualified and without insurance.
There are, we found subsequently, a couple of child seats in the car, so leads me to suspect that at some point she's been driving around with no licence or insurance, with children in the car, young children. So the females are claiming to have just bought the car, which is a regular story we often hear, that they've only just bought it. However, it's been driving around on these plates, we're quite confident, for at least a week. So at least it's today off the road, she won't be able to drive it with no licence or insurance anymore.
No legal action was taken against the woman for the false plates, but she was convicted of driving whilst disqualified and driving without insurance. She was banned from the roads for another 19 months, sentenced to 60 hours of unpaid work, and had to pay costs of £85. Lisa lets Rich do the honours.
On this occasion, Rich...
Oh, do I get to drive it?
You get to drive the...
Do you want to drive it?
No. I always drive him.
All right.
On this occasion, you can drive off and stall it and...
Make myself look a... All right, well.
He stood at the gate with a kitchen knife saying he's going to stab police.
Crime is on the rise.
Armed with an axe and a machete.
Trying to break into two separate houses.
But cometh the hour...
More units.
Cometh the interceptors.
Get on the floor!
Out and running.
We're riding with West Yorkshire's elite. Alongside their pursuit drivers.
Contact, stand by.
On target with their firearms unit.
There's no hope for you to fail us!
In the air with their eye in the sky.
Off and running.
This is the front line in the fight against crime.
Get on the floor! Get on the ground!
This is Police Interceptors.
It's just another day in paradise.
Coming up, a pursuit goes south on the northbound carriageway.
It's wrong way up the shoulder, back onto the 62 wrong way, M-Pass, if you could advise, please.
Dirty cash on the M62.
Send your phone! Get off the phone! Got it, mate.
Got it. There's a hell of a lot of money there.
And hide and seek with the air support unit.
Three of the drivers in the bushes, stop. Three police officers, the triangle of land with the bush to your right. Stop now, officer, hand in the air, stop, back. Come back to the tree, the triangle in front of you.
The M1. A million vehicles a week use this road. Most are legit. The rest belong to the interceptors, who are en route to the motorway to intercept a suspect van.
We've had a reliable sighting of a transit van coming north of the M1. It's got a stolen marker on it, which only went on this morning from the Salford area in Greater Manchester. So we're making our way from Leeds to the motorway network, where the M1 and the M62 meet.
Leaving afternoon traffic for dead, Gary McMaster. When he's not chasing bad guys, G-Mac's all about rugby and Monster Munch. Fast cars, hard tackles, big snacks. But he's got a taste for a Ford Transit today.
We're going to have some sighter cars and then some marked units to come up behind, and then we can all converge on it.
Leaving unmarked units to track the van, marked cars plot up at potential escape points.
I'll sit up here with these.
Gary and Emma are stationed off Junction 41 in case the target leaves the motorway. And after a quick rendezvous...
Bonjour.
How are
you?
Yeah, very well.
They take up position behind fellow interceptors.
Yeah, we've got two fuel units that have about 2 hours.
The plan is to box in the van with multiple cars.
Sounds great, Commit 241.
It's past the junction, so Gary and co rejoin the M1.
Feedback units, if you are on the exit slope, if you want to move up, please.
Now they're playing catch up, and it's the team at the next junction.
It needs to go right behind it. Get right behind it.
Who'll get first shot at the transit?
Get on side of it.
They surround the stolen van.
It's going around here. I think it's right.
But it beats the trap.
Yeah, it's going to go, lads. It's right to Rammers. It's going to go.
The suspect's taking major risks at motorway speeds.
Brakes, have you shown me your ground command, please? It's failing to stop. Speeds are now 70 mile an hour. You've got 13 pack units all around it.
As the transit leads the pursuing pack off the motorway...
Off at 28, please.
One interceptor is pushed wide onto the hard shoulder.
Go through. Yes, sir.
Where the driver's forced to stop in a cloud of dust.
It's not one. Approaching red lights.
The transit's trying to lose them on a roundabout.
Not three. Towards Leeds.
But a marked unit strikes.
Stop it.
Tactical contact, but it's not enough.
Yeah, it's wrong way up the shoulder, back onto the 62 wrong way, M Pass, if you could advise, please. Can I have units, please, to 27? Units to 27 ASAP.
The van's heading the wrong way on the
M62.
Cop cars hang back.
3-1, we are overhead and video.
But the air support unit doesn't.
3-1, it's still wrong way on the hard shoulder.
It's on the eastbound carriageway going westbound from the 28 towards 27.
It's going wrong way, it's going this direction.
4-0, we are at 27, we stayed on the network. We're just approaching 27 now.
Can I stay at the point at the entry to the lake, so we're just going to come off speed at the top there, please, if we can.
Praying the van comes off at junction 27, Gary and Emma plan to lay a stinger device to burst its tyres.
So far, we've stopped traffic coming off up onto Entrance from 27.
3-1 approaching 27, standby.
Fingers crossed.
3-1, it's off at 27. Standby.
Their prayers are answered, but they're too late to lay the stinger. And there she goes.
Head past 3-1, it's A62 Goldwood Road towards Leeds.
Gary finally has the van in his sights.
From your 4-0 confirm, we are behind this vehicle, we are car 1. It is still Goldwood Road, general direction of Cottonley Springs.
We didn't have time to get the stinger out of that junction.
Taking big risks with oncoming cars.
Can I confirm we've got a CPAP tap monitor in there?
The transit's flying.
4-0, speed is 80 miles an hour, still Goldwood Road. We are going to be able to get ahead of the vehicle to be able to get steam right in time.
Emma, try and get it to go left when it gets to the first garage along the ring road. I'll get a thing of sight
set up somewhere. Yeah, acknowledged. Want it to go left onto the ring road.
Gary needs to pull alongside and ease the van left towards the waiting stinger. But facing oncoming traffic at 80 miles per hour, something's got to give.
He's preventing me. He's going head on.
From your 4-0 confirm, we are behind this vehicle. We are car 1.
Interceptors are after 3 men in a stolen van.
Stop it!
It's already made a kamikaze run the wrong way down the M62.
It's one way, the 62 wrong way. Passage, you could advise, please. Can I have units, please, to 27?
It's going wrong way, it's going this direction.
And now Gary's trying to edge it left into the path of a Stinger team.
He's preventing me. He's going head on.
Gary's pulled out.
659 at
going right.
Because Van Man won't give an inch.
4-0, we couldn't get to the offside of it. It's taken right.
Onto the ring road, general direction towards the motorway network again.
A black clad arm at the passenger window.
Deposit it.
Second car.
Drop some
4-0, passenger's just deposited something out of its window. It's taken wrong way around the roundabout.
Leaving the package to local units, Gary hammers round the roundabout. Now he's second place in the pursuit.
Robbie Warren's the second car to by train. Black package thrown out to the driver's side on entrance roundabout. Sandy, I've got it. It's not a package, it's a padlock, so it's going to stuff the vehicle.
Whether they meant to damage cars or confuse the cops, they failed.
It is now Whitehall Road leads out of the city. Whitehall Road out of the city.
There it is. Got it there. There it is. Just going around bend.
Okay, I'm wearing it.
It's on that bend.
And it's right. Stand by. Walsh Lane.
With an unmarked on his bumper, Van Man leaves the main road.
Marked vehicles, turn right towards the yellow van.
Straight ahead.
In the rush to escape, the Transit clips the curb and blows two tyres.
It's popped its rear side and its front side. It's going to be a decamp shortly up there, say.
This is the end game. The van's pulling into a pub. Passengers' doors open. Driver's door.
It's a decamp in the pub car park, two out and running.
In fact, three have run in different directions with interceptors all over them. Emma's with a group chasing the two passengers.
Stay where you are!
The cops are closing in as the suspects vault a fence and head for the woods, leaving them to the long-distance runners.
I had to go back to the van.
Emma heads back in search of the driver.
3-1, driver's down round the rear of the pub. He's gone round the rear of the pub.
He's on his knees in the bush, but he hasn't a prayer.
3-1, the driver's in the bushes. Stop. 3 police officers, the triangle of land with the bush to your right. Stop now. Officer, hand in the air. Stop. Back. Come back to the tree. The triangle in front of you. There's a big bush.
Colder. Warmer. Warmer. Nicked. Now for the passengers, who've whittled down the pursuing pack to just one cop. The bad guys are through the hedge in a flash, but their pursuers hit a snag. Now, with a good head start, the men split up.
3-1, if I can get a unit to Tong Lane at Tong, that's the general direction they're going towards. If one unit can go to Tong Lane at Tong, please.
It's up 2-2, we're Tong Lane now.
One suspect is deep in the woods, but he can't hide from the thermal imaging camera.
Impost 2, and I've got an officer on a dirt track on foot. Go straight ahead and take your right fork. They'll be ahead of you.
Yep, got you.
He's got an interceptor on his tail.
Officer in the yellow top corner of the field. So you can get through the corner and go straight ahead along that farm track.
And more closing in. He's also running out of puff and heading straight for units at Tong Lane.
One of the males is going to head in that general direction.
As the suspect marches into thicker undergrowth and picks through the brambles, there's news on the other passenger.
One murder claim, three. I have got one. 3548, I've got one.
Received, so 2548's got one.
Two down, one to go. This is the last crimp standing. Meanwhile, at the crash site, the driver nicked in the bushes is loaded into an unmarked car, while the van he drove so dangerously gets a thorough search.
Got a set of two sets of number plates. No doubt they'll have been used at some point to put on to other vehicles to hide the true identity of the vehicle. Woo! Fair amount of generators within the back.
It's not uncommon for thieves to target construction sites to steal generators, which can be worth thousands.
can count at least 1, 2, 3, 4. There's about 6 generators in there. No doubt we'll come back stolen.
Not a bad afternoon's work so far.
At the minute, it's cops 2-1-0, I think, so far. But we'll see if we can get the third one.
3-1, if there's anything that can get to Corn Mill House off Mill Lane, it's the farm sort of below where we are near the pylons, they might be able to cut him off.
It's been an epic cross-country pursuit, but coming number 3, your time is up. An interceptor's bearing down on him, taser drawn.
He's just being detained now by an officer.
And then there were none.
Right, that's all 3 then, thank you.
That's all 3 in. Looks like a theft of motor vehicle and possibly a robbery. So they won't be going anywhere for a while.
The driver of the stolen van racked up a truckload of charges. He was found guilty of dangerous driving, driving whilst disqualified, and no insurance. He was sent to prison for 16 months. No further action was taken against him with regards to the stolen van or the suspected robbery. Both passengers were released without charge.
And this is why we come to work.
Bring the car around! Bring the car around!
When a crime's committed...
Right. Ooh. Get in the car! Get down!
Interceptors react like lightning.
They're running up to Bull Ride! They're running up to Bull Ride!
All over!
But prevention is better than a cure. And that's where the proactive intercept team comes in.
We've been set up to really get a grip of criminals that are using the roads of West Yorkshire as their playground for committing crime. Traffic, they're very similar to us, but they don't have the time to be going out and targeting these offenders that we have, so we're in a quite privileged position.
Armed with high-powered covert cars, Pitt's officers use key intelligence to stop major villains before they offend.
The tactics we use allows us to build up a picture of criminals, the vehicles they use. And sometimes we've only got a small opportunity if we know a vehicle's live in the area committing crime. It might only be live for a few days, so we've got to act quickly.
Which they frequently do.
Open the door now! Open the door, do it now!
Open the door now!
It's midday on the M62. And pit officers Harry and Steph are responding to intel from their most formidable source, the taxman.
We've received some information from our partners at HMRC. There's a vehicle, a VW Transporter in white, that's on the motorway network in possession of a large quantity of cash.
More than £100 billion in crime proceeds are laundered through the UK every year. Intercepting dirty money deals a direct blow to organised crime.
Yeah, it's looking like it's criminal property, this cash. So it's important we get it out of the criminal's hands and seize from him, really hit him in the pocket.
Big H comes from a long line of coppers, and by joining the high-speed pit team, he's bagged the best job in the family.
Yeah, we're in roughly the right area now. Possibly a little bit ahead of us.
The target, a white VW Transporter, is reportedly heading for Manchester, but that's all the information they have.
So we're just working through traffic as we can. Obviously, we don't want to get behind it and spook it.
But as they plot up on the motorway, the van has vanished.
We've not come across it and there's been no sightings. So we just plotted up. The information and intelligence from HMRC is that it will be coming through on the M62 to Manchester. So we've plotted up to see if it comes through, and then we've got the units in place to put a stop in.
This may be their one shot at seizing the cash.
It's very important that we get hold of this quickly before the money disappears. So we need to secure the evidence and the people in the car as quickly as possible.
It's just too risky for us to stop anything on the motorway using our discreet vehicles. So we're looking at following the vehicle till it comes off, coming up to a natural pause point such as, I don't know, red traffic light.
But first, they have to find it.
There, it's through.
The
Steph, you're cleared for takeoff. Steph spends his spare time blasting clay pigeons from the sky with a shotgun. But he'd rather bring down a van full of cash today.
Lads, it was one up white male driver, I think, by the looks of it.
Harry and Steph are part of a trio of covert cars designed to blend in with traffic and strike fast.
So vehicles come through now. There's one of our units ahead that are directly behind it. Almost. We're just keeping eyes on now, getting our units in place to allow us to put our tactics and get on the front foot a bit.
Ideally, the target van would pull off the motorway. The nearer he gets to Manchester, the more chance they have of losing him.
My intention that traffic runs too far. We don't know the destination of this vehicle.
They might be coming off the way.
Happy days.
What's this exit? 20.
Committed off and 20.
Committed on?
Off, I think he said.
He did. The target has left the motorway. Steph follows suit. And tucks in behind another pit BMW.
Lads, I still think he's just one in this. There's only one in front.
We're going to be alongside it, aren't we? So I'm going to be able to get out.
Two Beamers indistinguishable from everyday traffic.
Let the Golf clear, Fozzy. Let the Golf lights on.
Until they strike.
Got the phone.
What's on the clutch, mate?
It's on the clutch.
From stealth mode to full arrest in the time it takes to say you're nicked.
Did you put that in flight mode, mate?
Yes, mate.
They don't want anyone alerted to the arrest, so no calls in or out. The phone could contain vital contacts and intelligence.
Keep your foot in car, mate. Right, all in yours, mate.
Yeah.
Right, take a step out, mate.
Yeah, we're just putting one monitor back.
So we managed to get the vehicle stopped nice and safely, no damage, no injuries. Driver's been detained, we've secured the phone. We're going to get everyone off the network now and get it searched properly, get any offences dealt with.
An initial search of the VW turns up nothing. It's looking like the tip-off from the tax man may have been a red herring.
Yeah, that's like a 10.
If they don't find any cash, then the driver will be free to go. But this isn't the team's first rodeo.
A vehicle like this has many, many voids, so quite creative the way people want to hide things. So anything illicit may be hidden in body panels, they may create false panels or false voids. So at the moment we're just unscrewing some various panels because we think we've identified a void where there may be something hidden, so we're just looking into that area now.
Intel said there was a large sum of criminal cash on board, and after a full half an hour of searching, ka-ching!
So we've located a green bag, and contained within that green bag is various £20 notes. We don't know what sort of quantity, but there's a hell of a lot of money there. So, as you can see there, there's lots of bundles of £20 notes, two bags full. So looking at that, we're not looking at a few hundred pounds or a few thousand pounds, we're looking at tens of thousands of pounds. It may even run into six figures, so maybe hundreds of thousands of pounds. We don't know yet until it's counted.
The driver with a van full of dirty cash was charged with money laundering and awaits his day in court. The maximum sentence for such a crime is 14 years in prison. As for the money seized by the proactive intercept team, it was forfeited to the Crown, a sum well over £200,000.
A great bit of intel from our partners at HMRC. It's fantastic, so a great result, loads of cash recovered. So yeah, we're all chuffed, and on to the next one.
Still to come.
Quick, quick, quick. No, stay there, stay there.
Softly, softly, catchy quaddy.
Stop there!
And a suspect has weed in his fuel tank.
Thought I could smell it.
It's a red agricultural quad, travelling at 50 miles an hour.
When it comes to intimidating sights on the roads, few things beat a masked man on a quad bike.
He's taken a right, 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 and he's off-road, off-road.
Their off-road advantage and strict rules on pursuing them has long given quad riders the upper hand. But West Yorkshire has recently levelled the playing field.
Come on, you. Come on!
Clearing trained interceptors to make tactical contact. So, in the battle between cops and quads, that was then.
It's going to be a loss, loss. We've had to abort, he's been off road again.
This is now. It's a glorious summer day, and Ben and Matt are on patrol in sunny Saltaire.
Just had some intelligence that there's an off-road quad up and down Saltaire Road in the top part of Eldwick, and that is a very, very affluent area. The gentleman's got a balaclava on.
The gentleman must really feel the cold.
It's not, I know it's sunny, but let's be honest, it's still 22 degrees. You don't really need to be wearing a balaclava. So they're only wearing a balaclava to put fear into people.
Benny Boy's seen more balaclavas than your average ski instructor, and he's not convinced that Quadman got lost on his way to the Alps.
Now, I'm not saying it's anything to do with burglaries, but there's a lot of poaching going on up there and a lot of people sussing houses out, so we're going to make his way up, try and drop on this quad and see what happens.
Whatever they're up to, interceptors have little time for masked riders scaring residents.
They try and use quads because they're a little bit more intimidating. A lot of people, Mr. and Mrs. Miggins, don't know how to take these vehicles. Quick, quick, quick. No, stay there, stay there.
He's making off. But it's a less than great escape. Gently, little nudge, and leg it.
Stop there!
Wow, what's that? I'm not resisting. Wow.
Don't you just love it when a plan comes together?
Tactical contact. We work every time. I put it to bed, pushed it out of the way, and I've stopped him. You can see fear on his face and say, we're not mucking about, we're not pursuing you, and I'm going to push you off quad straight away. So, slight little bit of damage up front of the car, but it's worked a treat. I'm happy with that.
What's your name?
Keenan.
Anything on you, Keenan?
What's that?
Anything in your pockets?
No. Beldon Road in Beldon. We've got one male detained. We're just going to try and find out if this quad's stolen at the moment.
Yeah, I received. I put a log on for you.
Hello.
Right.
You're right. Who's his bike?
My mate's.
Stolen?
My mate's.
No. Just no docs?
My mate's stolen bike.
All right. You got license?
No.
What's the point in trying to go then?
I don't know what I'd do. With
I know. Tactical contact, mate, all day long. We'll just shove you off it. We'll box you in now and push you off it, ram you all day long.
Don't know that I do that.
Yeah. New rules, sunshine. So just think on next time, yeah?
And think on whose bike you've been riding.
So who's your friend that owned this quad? You don't know his name, but he's letting you his quad. Do you want to believe that?
He may have a balaclava, but he won't pull the wool over Matt's eyes.
Do you believe that? Yeah? So I think it's stolen then?
It's not stolen.
Whose quad is it then? So we can verify it? Because otherwise what will happen is you're going to get locked up for theft of motor vehicle. Okay. Who? Looking from my perspective. You've seen us. You tried to make off. You're wearing a balaclava.
All right. I need some details. We want the quad.
so they can come here with some documentation. Other than that, you're getting locked up for theft of motor vehicle because you can't find his chassis number on it.
You could use up your phone a friend if you could remember his name.
So who's it? Think fast.
You don't know whose quad it is? Is it stolen?
No, it's stolen.
Where have you got it from?
My mate.
Who's that?
Right, are you going to tell us who that is? Right.
On CSIU controller.
He don't know whose it is. He don't know who owns it, so currently it's going to be reported as stolen, so he's going to elect a theft of motor vehicle. So, positive result for us. No damage. Well, when I say no damage, I've just looked at front bumper. There's a slight few marks, but no injuries or all that. So, good response. Happy. So, it's Romeo 3-2.
The lad with the balaclava and short memory was reported for driving without insurance. With no proof that the quad was stolen, no action was taken in regards to the allegation of theft. But after his gentle brush with the law, hopefully he'll give quads a wide berth in the future.
We're happy, and it just goes to prove that the tactics that we have and what we're taught work and work to a T. If you saw, he didn't have a clue what day it was, and he were out of his depth completely. That's what we want to do and what we want to achieve. So just let you know we are out there, we are doing it, and it does work. So if you're on a stolen motorbike or a stolen quad, you better be careful.
There's cannabis in there, but I can't get my frigging hand in.
A typical interceptor boasts many virtues. Diligence.
That's got cannabis in it.
Humility. Even chastity.
You kidding me?
I definitely would not.
If I was off the shift.
If I was off the shift, no, I definitely would not.
But when it comes to bagging bad guys...
Yeah, that's where it went last time.
It's all about patience.
We are after a grey Punto that has been... We were looking for it last week. It's been involved in a few make-off without payments. So he's been going to petrol stations, filling up and driving off. So it would be a bit of a target, yeah.
It's mid-afternoon and the two Chrises are seeking the one that got away.
So we're sort of tracking it before and we're just trying to remember the different routes that it went last time.
After 14 years on the force, Chris knows all the tricks, including the fact that drivers often use the same routes when trying to lose the cops.
What's that up there, Chris? See it?
Great car.
Yeah, that's it, innit?
Did indeed, mate.
That's the one.
X-ray Romeo 4-6. We are behind the vehicle now. Just heading to Castleford. Stand by for street name.
Is your other units coming?
Yeah, I'm coming towards you.
It's fair to say that they won't lose the suspect Punto this time.
Yeah, I see you coming towards me to get it.
With Chris and Chris leading a three-car convoy...
We'll put stop in.
All the pieces are in place. And it's checkmate.
Engine off.
Yeah.
Jump out.
I've done nothing wrong.
Jump out. Take a seat.
A collar 7 days in the making and well worth the wait.
And it's a stop.
A familiar smell leads Chris to search the Punto and the interceptors turn up.
Thought I could smell it.
An interesting discovery behind the fuel cap.
More bag of cannabis just fine.
One bag of weed.
He's obviously secreted it in the petrol tank. Where he's been nicking out fuel, ironically.
To add to the suspect's woes...
It is shown as insured on PNC, but there's shown insured to a different vehicle.
It looks like he's uninsured.
It's shown as make and model as a Vauxhall Corsa, Club CDTI, and this is not a Vauxhall Corsa.
He claims his brother sorted the policy.
So I'll just have to ring my brother now to send an email right now to you, then...
Chris patiently helps check with the insurance company.
Right, and then would they have all been sent via email? I'd imagine.
You can send them in via email. If you want to put them on, I can give them a list of everything that we need.
Yeah.
If you send them in via email, we'll be able to make the change as soon as we receive them.
Lovely. I'll pass you on to him in case he's got any questions.
Hello. Hello.
It's not insured. That's what they've said.
Yep.
They even get the suspect's brother on the phone.
That certificate makes no difference because I've just spoke to the underwriters. It is not on cover. I'll tell you what then, I'll just report your brother for no insurance and I'll see his car.
Well, that's fine. You take the car. You take the car. Give him up. Give
Chris
him
up gets no thanks for trying to help. And while one brother rants on the phone, the other follows suit in the car.
I don't want that. I don't want the camera to listen to me clearly yet. I don't want my phone coming up, man. Yeah, I see you caught. Hurry up and give me. Put my phone out of my car. Hurry up, man. I'm time for this morning. You two want to be.
So you do not have to say anything, but it may have a defence
if you do not mention when questioned.
I'll tell you what then. Section 5A. Let's try this.
Motormouth has also earned himself a drug wipe.
Right, my colleague found some cannabis in your car because it smelled of cannabis. That's why he searched it, all right? So because of that, I require you to provide me a sample of saliva at the roadside for testing. And stick your tongue out and lean forward. Stick your tongue right out.
Just to let you know, the cannabis is found outside the vehicle in the petrol cap, officer. It's a trade vehicle, mate, yeah? So we'll see you in court, mate.
I never said I was arresting you for cannabis.
You've just done a breathalyzer on me.
I've just swabbed you.
You don't come,
because
you
smell
just swabbed me. I don't smell no cannabis, mate.
Yes, you do. I suspect you're driving. It doesn't matter if it's in a petrol cap.
You're a ginger bastard, aren't you?
Oh, wow. Aren't you an absolute delight?
You ugly little tramp.
Oh, my
ginger
gosh.
Nuts. You haven't got money like us, mate. Now, will do. Trust me, you're a pair of bonkers. We may see this money, mate.
Here we go.
Listen, suck on me, Vinny. Do something useful.
Wow.
I've seen a little bastard.
Like dealing with a child.
What's the saggy mother again? Limbred bastard. You, yeah, hurry up, yeah? Peace takers, mate. Take me down, shop. Take me down, shop, you son of a bitch. I don't pay. I've done 6 years in jail, I'll do it again. No bother to me, you daft.
Don't bother me, I'm still going to get paid at the end of the day.
I get paid as well, mate. I'm getting paid right now still. It doesn't bother me, mate. I've got more money than you and what?
I'm not particularly bothered how much you're worth.
I've got an RS6, I've got an RS7. Will you take them off me?
And you're driving a Fiat Punto?
Yeah, off his blender, isn't it, you daft?
Yeah, of course you are.
Yeah.
Chris is a low-temperature copper with the patience of a saint.
This is a drugs wipe. It tests for cannabis and cocaine. At the bottom, there is only one line and there's nothing on the test line, so that means you've tested negative for
bingo,
cocaine.
Bingo! Bingo! Ginger nuts. Hurry up, man. I've got time for... Get me out of this car. I want to go home.
He ain't finished yet.
I don't care, mate. I want to go home.
On the top line, you've tested positive for cannabis. So at this stage, you are under arrest on suspicion of driving your motor vehicle whilst over the prescribed limit.
That's cuffs.
Okay, so you do not have to say anything, but it may harm your defence if you do not mention now.
I'm going to get you for...
Do not have to say that it may have a defence. Do not mention when questioned something later on in court. Anything you do say may be given evidence. Your arrest is necessary, but you need to take it to the police station for a blood sample.
Where are your cigs?
In the front.
Not too tight?
Yeah, I will be all right anyway because I haven't had it for 2 days. I know for a fact it's going to be under anyway on that.
Oh, that's fine. That's entirely up to you, mate.
All right, Ginger knows, don't worry about it. Come on,
I'm not worried. I'm not in a rush.
Buzzing me, trust me.
You're under arrest at the moment.
If you can keep your head while all around are losing theirs, you'll be an interceptor, my son. No further action was taken regarding the cannabis in the petrol flap, or the alleged making off without payment. After failing a blood test, the driver was charged with drug driving and no insurance, but he failed to attend court and is now a wanted man. He'll turn up. All the interceptors need is patience. Still to come.
What are you getting out good?
When Claire gets accosted at the drive-through.
What do you mean?
From here.
Yeah.
Have you ordered?
Fish fillet meal.
It's a potential hostage situation.
Let's not do that.
I did worry for a short amount of time though that I might have been kidnapped.
Since the end of tax discs in 2014, the number of untaxed road users in the UK has almost trebled. But police have been given new powers to seize these vehicles, and it's proving popular with the interceptors.
I think the new power that the DVLA have given us...
Seizure powers.
Yeah, it's absolutely fantastic.
Bob on, innit? Bob on. West Yorkshire Police have seized hundreds and hundreds...
I wouldn't like to say, mate. In the first six months? Yeah, I wouldn't like to say how many.
Hundreds of cars that are not taxed. Take them off road.
It's a wet night in the city centre, and Claire and Bobo are tailing a performance Golf that's showing us no tax or insurance.
It's there.
It's a Golf. I said that would go. Is it stopping? It's not going to stop. Oh.
They think the driver's making off as he ignores blue lights and weaves through a car park.
He's trying to get out in here. Yeah. Romeo 30. Yeah, he's gone to the thing.
It's a dry snow.
But it seems this guy was just in a rush to get to the front of the queue.
Yeah, just stand by.
The Golf is hidden in drive-through traffic.
How am I going to get him out of there now? He's going, going.
The only place he's going is the order window.
I don't know what he's doing. I can't decide. Right, let me try again. You all right?
Yeah.
I thought you were trying to get away then.
No.
Is it your car?
Yeah.
All right.
I just purchased it today.
All right, OK. Yeah. It's not showing no insurance and stuff.
The drive-through line isn't the easiest place to interview a suspect.
Sorry about that.
Have you just ordered food?
Yeah. It's not like...
But Claire's got bigger fish to fry than his food order.
It's showing no insurance, that's why we're coming to speak.
Along with no MOT, it's also showing as not being insured. This is the point when Claire would normally invite him into her car for a chat.
Sit in the car if you like, just for a minute, honestly.
But this guy's obviously never seen police interceptors, so Claire accepts his invitation.
Where'd you buy it from?
I just bought it from you.
On tax since February.
What if I get taxed now? I don't know what day it will.
Right, so have you not taxed it?
I don't know what day it will. Right.
Go through here, because you can get your food.
This could be a very expensive burger.
I just bought the car now, obviously I don't want it taken off me.
Right.
I suppose for me to get taxed on it quickly.
No.
It'll take me a minute.
No, because once they're on tax... No.
It's going to cost me about £150 to get out of compound. I just purchased the car.
Yeah, I see what you're saying. But what you need, it's your responsibility, isn't it, to have it taxed, insured, MOT'd, all that.
You know what, I'll just come here now just to buy food then.
A quick update back to Bobo.
We're just going through the drive-through. He's bought it.
Today, this car, he's just getting his insurance documents up.
He ain't got his tax up, has he? Because that expired in February.
I know, I've just showed him that. I've got it on my phone here.
He's not taxed it.
It turns out he does have insurance, but not having an MOT means one thing.
In March this year, the DVLA gave us some new powers, and if we stop a car that's out of tax by 2 months and a day, then we seize the car. It doesn't cost you £150, it costs you £100 within 24 hours and you get it taxed.
Still low, it's like...
I know, but do you know what I mean?
I wanted to drive the car today. It's Saturday as well, and Sunday I don't like the compound.
Yeah. No, it will be. They're open 24 hours a day.
Just like the drive-thru.
How are you all right?
£500.
The man is facing a hefty fine, but you can't fault his manners.
Do you want anything?
No, I'm good, thank you. Are you sure? What are you getting out good?
Although there's no accounting for taste.
Yeah.
Have you ordered?
Fish fillet
meal. Ah. I always end up in these strange situations. Every time.
Yeah, you can eat that.
Every time. Let's not do that.
And it seems he needs to brush up on his driving skills.
You are doing it. Oh, sorry.
Just park up here because I need to check this door. I don't even know your driver's license details or anything like that. Just park up here. There you go. There's a nice little space where you can show me your reversing skills.
No pressure.
Oh, guess what?
Oh, what has happened?
I just saw the thing as well.
It's like the weirdest buddy-buddy movie ever.
Right, just turn your engine off and come and have a sit in back of our car. I'll bring your food with you if you want. There you go. Jump in there. I've let him bring his food with him.
Bobo, meet Claire's new partner. He's a bit of a maverick, but at least he likes to share.
No, you're right, Chief. Just eating.
Come on, you stressed me out, man.
You stressed me out. I thought we were going to have a pursuit through McDonald's drive-through.
And Claire and Bobo have a bigger takeaway in mind, one with no road tax.
Do you need anything out of the car?
Go grab what you need.
You got the key?
Yeah, we got the key, yeah.
Can you just unlock the car for me?
Yeah, I've unlocked it.
It's a lift home for the lad and another untaxed car to add to the statistics.
I did worry for a short amount of time though that I might have been kidnapped.
Yeah.
I started revving it and I was like, oh my God, I'm going to be kidnapped. What am I going to do? Am I going to code zero or something? What would I do in that situation?
Well, you didn't need to because I were here. I was just going to stuff him into the fence. Yeah.
I'd have been like, Bobo's kidnapped. Get me out.
It's the one and only MVP. Make sure you tune on Channel 5 for Bellator London, 10 o'clock, November 23rd.
Next tonight, revenge could come with a heavy price tag in our original drama, Cold Call.
He stood at the gate with a kitchen knife saying he's going to stab police.
Crime is on the rise.
Armed with an axe and a machete.
Trying to break into two separate houses.
But cometh the hour.
My unit.
Cometh the interceptors.
Get on the floor!
Out and running.
We're riding with West Yorkshire's elite.
Come on!
Alongside their pursuit drivers.
Contact, stand by.
On target with their firearms unit.
There's no hope, we're the killers!
In the air with their eye in the sky.
Off and running.
This is the front line in the fight against crime.
Get on the floor! Get on the ground!
This is Police Interceptors.
It's just another day in paradise.
Coming up.
3-0, that's me requesting CPAP.
A decam from a moving car.
Stop it!
A smash and run in Bradford.
It was a white car, it drove off up the road, and it was smoking like a good one.
And the loud arm of the law.
Give me your arm!
I'm giving it.
It's Tuesday night, and all is quiet, with one exception. Blazing towards Saltaire, district officers are after a stolen Vauxhall Astra with fake plates.
Stop the clone Astra.
And to coin a local phrase, it's going like the clappers.
It's currently 70 miles an hour, Saltaire. Stand by.
The good news is it's headed straight for interceptor Kev Shaw.
X-ray Romeo 3-0. I'm in Shipley. I'll go to that clone vehicle one.
Kev's a cop of consummate taste. He loves red wine, meat pies, and salt and vinegar crisps. And really hates car thieves.
The scum. There's people working hard every day just to have some nice things, and then you get scumbags who then turn up and just see something nice in your driveway and think, we want that.
It's fair to say that Kev's keen to feel their collars. And there they go. Out accelerating local cops, the interceptor takes the lead. Kev plans to catch up and box the car in.
3-0, that's me requesting CPAP.
But up ahead, the driver's door pops open. This guy abandons ship, leaving it to stack straight into a parked hatchback. With the passenger door open, the Astra slams into a stationary car. Its fleeing passengers are a whisker away from getting crushed. Kev aims to cut the suspect off in the next street. Pulling alongside the running man, he blocks the pavement. But the lad's over the bonnet and off like a shot.
Stop it! Out and running! Wharton Street, white male. Jogging top bottoms that added us in blue baseball cap.
Kev's dropped his baton. And the time it takes to retrieve it, he's lost him.
Sorry, where are you?
Jonathan Silverbill, I don't know what...
But the suspect breaks cover.
Get up, Marcus. Get down!
Tottenham Exhibition Road.
Stop for you.
Give me up!
I'm getting on it. Turn around on your brother. Give us your arm. Give us your arm. Stay
where
down.
The
stay down. 3-0, I've got the driver. Unit to me, please.
Kev suspects this is the driver.
Yeah, can we have a unit to Exhibition Road, please?
And as the cavalry rides in...
Hey, up. Not so bad. Move on your side, fella.
The atmosphere's altogether more convivial.
Sit up.
And when an off-duty officer jogs in to assist, it's a right old copper's reunion.
Hi, Kev.
Hey, mate, how you doing?
All right.
Any more?
I mean, we've got a driver.
Shut up.
Kev, any more?
Not going down this way. They went a different way.
All right, good.
All right, see you later on.
No worries.
Chit-chat over.
Can I stand up, mate?
No, you're sitting down.
It's back to the suspect.
2-3.
Yeah.
There you go.
2 Romeo, 3-0. We've got clarification on this vehicle.
Who's playing dumb?
How come you chose that
car? It's an outstanding stroller from Bradford.
I wasn't chasing it. My colleagues were chasing it and you failed to stop. So, I've chased you.
And caught you.
Under arrest and special belt stop for police. And dangerous driving. And caution still stands. Do you understand?
Ask the audience. Phone a friend.
Do you understand?
No.
Well, you understand you're arrested, yes?
Yeah, I know.
You understand why I've arrested you?
Second time lucky.
Dangerous driving, failed stop for police in a stolen vehicle. Does that make it any clearer?
I failed to stop for police. I've been in the car. I ain't stopped for police, yeah.
You're sorry?
The car ain't stopped for police. I ain't drove. I ain't very good.
Right.
He admits he was in the car, but claims he wasn't driving.
Right, jump in.
Either way, he's about to be a passenger in the back of the van, while Kev assesses the damage.
Oh, great. That's knackered now.
To his phone and himself.
I'm nearly 42-year-old and, as Danny Glover said in Lethal Weapon, I'm too old for this.
But the old eyes have still got it.
He's trying to claim that he's the passenger. I've seen him get out from the driver's side and then I've followed him down this road here where I've tried to head him off. He's made me run. How dare he? And then I dropped my baton. And luckily, he stopped for a breath himself, hiding behind a parked car. And I've got him, so happy days, one to me.
Luckily, Kev won't have to rely on his eyes to see who was driving.
I'll have to just see from video if he has got out from the driver's seat. I won't know that until it uploads and I have a look at it.
The video can be viewed back at the station. Bradford Nick, here we come. Or maybe not.
Have you got to look for the keys?
Yes. Right. I'm just looking for my key fob because it's fallen off my key.
Okay, fob.
Shrewd detective work pays off.
And I've got my key, yes. If I hadn't found this, I'd have had to buy buns for his shift, so it saved me some money.
Bradford Nick. Here we come.
I bet you forgot to press record today, didn't you?
Thank you.
With the comedy short out of the way, it's time for the main feature.
Is that a turn?
It's an action movie with a sting in the tail for its leading man, who exits stage right from the driver's seat.
It's driver. Yeah, Mappy, it's driver. So there was a person who got out of the passenger seat, the rear public passenger seat, but he was definitely driver.
The lad leaping from a moving car was found guilty of theft of a vehicle, driving whilst disqualified and driving without insurance. He was disqualified for a further 19 months and sentenced to 15 months at Her Majesty's pleasure.
You're currently disqualified.
Coming up...
Told me to go forth on multiply several occasions.
Claire gets an earful...
You've been detained.
Been detained for... What, you got me slightly for? Bullshit on my phone.
An interceptor sandwich on the M62.
So it's that car there.
Yeah, seen it.
And Sherlock Spenner's on the case.
It's VW.
The UK is suffering an attack of the clones, with villains copying legit number plates onto similar cars for dodgy deeds.
No.
Incidents of cloned cars on the UK's roads have almost doubled since last year.
Ambulance now, please.
Nick Priestley is making his way to the motorway. The dodgy motor is straying onto their patch.
So we've had a hit on the motorway coming into our area on an old Volvo. It's a 55-plate Volvo. Very brief details at the moment. It's been involved in theft from vehicles. But there's no keeper with it, and it's insured to the northeast. So it's a good chance it could be a clone vehicle, this.
With 23 years service, this veteran cop has aspirations to test himself with a marathon and the Ironman challenge. But tonight, it's a team effort.
How many X5 we got down here?
You've got two maybe, I guess.
The plan is to box the Volvo in a T-pack manoeuvre. Nick prepares his troops.
So to confirm, Fliss, you're going to the front with your follow-on. James, you'll go to offside and I'll go to the rear. And Ben C, if you act as unofficial safety.
Yes, received. It'll be 3-4 then.
With the Volvo approaching, the two X5s take the lead and creep up the slip road.
It's one up, just got passed up.
They have the motor in their sights.
So it's that car there.
Yeah, seen it.
It's time to T-pack. The suspect has nowhere to go and doesn't put up a fight. The dodgy meat in an interceptor sandwich.
Just come over, stop.
Volvo drivers are known for their courtesy, but this one's missed the memo. Cunning disguise. He's quickly in cuffs.
Can you get out?
And popped into a colleague's car.
What's your name, mate?
Liam Jagger.
Liam Jagger?
Yeah.
Is it your car, Liam Jagger?
No, it's not.
Right. Have you got a driving licence, Liam Jagger?
No, I'm banned.
You're banned, all right, me, Liam Jagger. No worries, we'll sort it out.
No worries.
While Nick deals with the clone mobile, Liam is taken to local services for further questioning. It seems he's a banned driver who's been taken off the road thanks to some tasty T-pack work.
From a tactics point of view, I wouldn't say it was textbook because none of it is. However, we made the decision for him, and I think he quite rightly realised that I aren't going anywhere, and he pulled in and sort of pretty much says, right, enough's enough.
Nick arrives at the services where Claire Gray and Dan Pennington have the suspect in hand.
disqualified until the 1st of August 2020, and then after that you'd have to take a test. So you're currently disqualified.
It turns out the lad has recently been released from prison for dangerous driving after he failed to stop earlier in the year.
No deviation. Stand by.
That pursuit lasted 25 minutes over 10 miles.
Back in the direction where he originally came from.
Involved the suspect driving three loops round a housing estate at 60 miles an hour.
No deviation. Stand by, and it's a right, right, right.
And only ended when the police used a stinger to stop the car, eventually dragging the suspect out.
Stop, stop, stop.
He got 10 months for that offence, but was released early. He's currently wearing a tag and on a curfew.
How long are you on curfew for?
I've just been given it last week.
Was that an early release from prison then and put on your curfew?
No, I've already had that one. I've already completed that. This is for not going to community service. Breach of it, breach of my order in it.
Tagging is meant to encourage good behaviour, but it doesn't seem to be working for this lad.
Have you changed the plates on the car, or did you get it with them plates on?
I bought the car, how the car is now. I don't know nothing about no plates.
Right, OK. Because the number plates that are on it are not the true identity of the car.
That's not my problem.
Right.
As they continue to question the suspect, Nick inspects the handiwork.
Exactly. It's knackered, but it looks all right, and you probably won't think of stopping it. Had it not been for the cameras that's identified that it's a clone car, probably won't look twice. And that is your pool car.
A pool car is shared between criminals to commit less than legal shenanigans.
Very little cost, easy to run, easy to maintain, because it's pretty much free, no insurance, no licence. The Kentucky kid.
Meanwhile, the cloned kid, like a lot of millennials, seems to be having some separation anxiety with his mobile phone.
Not on my phone?
No, not at the minute.
Well, if I'm not under arrest, why not?
Because you might be under arrest in a minute. We're just doing some inquiries.
Excuse me, until I'm under arrest, I'm allowed my phone, obviously.
Right. Well, not at the minute, no, because you're detained.
I'm not under arrest yet. Don't make it, do you know what I mean? I'm not running off nowhere. I want my phone, do you know what I mean? You're just playing on your phone, I can't play on my phone.
It's not a phone that I'm playing on.
Plenty of TV programme, you know, fat bald bastards, don't they? Grow up.
It doesn't seem the cloned kid is a fan of the Interceptors, but he does want to brag about his big boy driving skills.
Looking. Smoke off, man, you know, all your lives.
Well, there we go, then. That's exactly why we stopped you in the manner that we did.
You're lucky I didn't.
There's no luck.
Still being me, shit, and you're still being a dickhead.
There's no luck in it.
Well, I'm not under arrest, why am I going to be in cuffs? I've not got my phone, I want to make a call.
Because you've been detained.
Been detained for what? You've got me sat here for bullshit on my phone?
Claire does her best to reason with him.
You're a disqualified driver, you just... prison.
Well, I'm under arrest, why haven't I got my phone?
You're in a car.
You've arrested me until I'm under arrest, why haven't you given me my phone?
Well, I've tried to answer you, but you won't listen.
I've tried to answer you, but I want my phone. I'm not under arrest, why do you need my phone?
Interceptors have to deal with this level of abuse on a daily basis. But for Claire, it's water off a duck's back.
Told me to go forth on multiply several occasions. Didn't take kindly to being interviewed, I don't think, about the matter. Probably because he knows he's banged to rights and he shouldn't be driving. It's a good job that we stopped him in the manner that we did, because he's recently been disqualified for dangerous driving, so I don't think he'd think twice about failing to stop for the police. Another idiot off our roads.
The cloned kid packs up his belongings.
How big are them boots? Like Mary Poppins' handbag. Ain't got a lampshade in there, have you?
The Bobos.
Both he and the car are off the road, but Nick isn't convinced for how long.
I have to say that I'm absolutely over at the moment about getting him off the road, but he will be one of Bradford's finest drivers that will never stop driving. He will never, ever be legal, that lad. He's just one of our everyday customers.
For this offence of driving while disqualified and without insurance, and his previous offence, he got a total of 10 months behind bars. He was further disqualified from driving for 17 months. The world of TV is littered with famous crime-fighting partnerships. Holmes and Watson, Mulder and Scully, and of course, West Yorkshire's very own Spedder and Kev. They're responding to an incident in the northeast of the city centre.
There's been a report from them to the public that they've seen a car crash into a parked car. They then heard some people arguing. I think someone's been heard to say, come on, let's go, or something like that. Which has got all the hallmarks this time of the Friday night that he's going to be a drunk driver. It's only really scant information. We're trying to get it down there as quickish as we can to see if we can find it.
When Spenner isn't working, he likes to unwind by watching crime drama. His favourite film is The Equalizer, and his top fictional detective is Tosh Lines from The Bill. And he's got his own mystery to solve tonight, the case of the trashed Toyota.
Yeah, we're not going at a minute. I'll just put you on your way up there. But we might see you later.
See you, Richard.
The hatchback has been collided into by another car, but the suspect has scarpered.
Whose car is it then?
Oh, it's mine.
Is it yours?
Just
right.
Incidents of drivers leaving the scene of a collision have increased by 45% over the last 4 years. However, this crash has a witness, the car owner's neighbour who called the cops.
What car is it what drove off?
It was a white car. It drove off up the road and it was smoking like a good un.
But it will take more than a bit of smoke to hide from this interceptor duo.
I think the main thing we can do is just go try and see if we can find another car for you. I don't think it's going to be difficult to find it because there's going to be a car that's absolutely wrecked if it's caused that much damage to the back of yours.
And the suspect has left behind a vital clue.
I think that's off the front of that car as well.
Is it?
It
ain't
off of that car.
It's a piece of their car. Detective Spenner, an expert in cars, takes a closer look at the clues.
It's a VW.
Boom. They're after a white VW with a big dent.
But we'll see if we can go find this car, all right?
They're one step closer to bringing some justice to the innocent owner of the Toyota.
Oh, Lord.
I have to feel sorry for that guy, bless him. He's minding his own business, parked car, outside his house, law-abiding citizen, and then someone's just smashed into the back of his car and obviously just done one.
Spenner senses the suspect car will be nearby.
It's going to be damaged, so I don't think it's going to be too far away. Our best bet now is to have a look around this estate. I can't see it's gone very far.
And there's a white VW up ahead.
Trash.
That's it.
That's it there, yeah.
This may not be the car that they're looking for. Then again, that's a pretty big clue. Blue paint on a mangled wing.
5-1, we've found the vehicle involved.
But it's far from case closed.
We may never find out who was driving it, but there's a ways and means and there's a process now that we can follow to do our best to at least help this poor lad out who's had his car destroyed. Being a betting man, I would say that she's driving it, she's drunk, she's crashed it, thought, oh no. So she's dumped it, she's run away to try avoid any repercussions.
Spenner's prime suspect, the registered owner. There are no leads on her location, so it's back to the scene of the crime to break the news about the car.
The car's just down there. It's been abandoned, yeah. I don't fully know who's driving it yet, but I'm going to give you all the details your insurance company will need, all right?
Insurance claims such as these are an inconvenience. However, the victim is philosophical.
I'm just going to call insurance and go from there, but I'm just glad it's not a person. It's someone out there who's been hit. You ain't seen a car, it's better for that to happen, isn't it?
Upside, it shouldn't cost you anything because, as I say, this car's all insured. I've got all the details you'll need.
Oh, that's fantastic, thank you.
So that's a massive bonus for you.
And there's another potential bonus in the case. The neighbours discovered that the crash has been caught on CCTV.
Because my neighbour over the road, she said they were last driving.
It's a serious smash, and it looks like they've got the right car.
The car went up.
But it's impossible to get an ID on the driver. Kev and Spenner do have the registered address of their prime suspect, and with the insurance sorted, they're off to pay her a visit.
See you in a bit.
And we're going to serve with some paperwork now. That means she, because the car's registered to her, it's her responsibility to tell us who's driving it. If she doesn't do that, then she will be prosecuted with failing to furnish those details. So we're going to go knock on the door, we'll go, and if she's not there, we'll serve that paperwork.
You feel for him, don't you?
So it'd be nice to get this guy some sort of justice.
There's someone home.
Who is it?
Will it be the suspect driver?
Rob?
He's in. Yeah.
She's not living here, Rob. What's happened? I'm a mum.
She's crashed a car and walked off.
You're joking.
No. I'm just going to post this through because the car is registered to this address.
Yeah.
I'm going to post this through. It's for her to get in touch with me as soon as possible.
Right.
Unfortunately, they were unable to prove that she was driving the car, and so the case was dropped at court. Thankfully, the victim's insurance paid out and they got a new car. Coming up...
I've got eyes on her. She is waiting in the last window now.
A drink driver at the drive-thru.
And she's moving onto the roundabout now. She's taking the first, heading out.
And a Kentucky Fried litter bug gets his mate's car seized.
That this guy threw something. I haven't even seen him.
Right, but we have. So we've stopped you.
Blood, they're trying to get onto me because you dashed it in, apparently. Blood.
Drink drivers continue to cause havoc on West Yorkshire's roads.
Right, I was expected you failed that.
And the worst offenders?
Come on.
Oh, my Jesus, Lord, how pissed are you?
Young adults under the age of 30.
Give me your arm, give me your arm!
Stop resisting.
Just south of Bradford, interceptors are after a suspected boozed-up motorist.
We'll be taking lead 102. We are now ground commander. Requesting feedback authority, no deviation.
He's weaving more than Muhammad Ali as he tries to throw them with a dummy left. But the interceptors aren't going to be fooled. The runaway Focus approaches a red light and the lead police car spots an opportunity to get in front. But he's just nudged out.
And so a right onto Batley Road. You know the traffic.
The streets might be quiet, but he's being reckless.
Going through reds at the crossroads, it's no deviation, speed is 40 miles an hour.
Despite the low speed, his driving is high risk, as he again weaves on the wrong side of the road.
Approaching some red traffic lights.
And runs yet another red.
Stand by. And it's straight through.
Luckily, there are very few people about. Although this cat is now down to 8 lives. The runaway pulls another move from the drink driver handbook. Wrong way, down a one-way.
And it's a straight across, no entry.
But he can't shake them. He's back on the wrong side of the road. Up some cobbles.
Oh, stick over cobbles. Yes, you can do.
Over the speed bumps. But his efforts to escape are in vain. And after a 7-minute pursuit, he's on the ropes.
He's given up.
Albeit with a tidy handbrake finish. Speaking of which, let's see those hands, son.
Stop. No damage to the detained.
He's nicked and blows 83 at the roadside, over twice the legal limit. the driver was convicted of aggravated vehicle taking, driving under the influence of alcohol and without insurance. He received 8 months imprisonment and was disqualified for 3 years and 4 months. Over in Wakefield, Duncan Matthews is responding to reports of another drink driver, this time at a drive-thru. Dunk pulls up nearby while staff turn fast food into slow food until the cavalry arrives.
Trying to delay her. They've said that she's at the third window waiting for food. They're trying to hold her there as long as possible.
X-ray Delta 68, I'm coming. I'm parked up there now. I've got eyes on her. She is waiting at the last window now. Staff have been trying to delay her, keep her at the window. They think she's been drinking. So we're just trying to get a couple of units into the area now. Wait for her to move off, and once she moves off, we can try and stop her.
This bungee-jumping, white water-rafting copper is fond of a curry, but the suspect seems to prefer a burger. And dinner is served.
And she's moving off. I'm just parked up near the Costa, just watching her move up. She's moving off to the roundabout now. She's taking the first, heading out towards the 650.
Duncan is waiting for a backup before pulling her over.
On approach to the roundabout, at it, and we've got a near side indication. Taking the first. It's the A61 going out towards Leeds. Speed 30.
A local unit has now arrived. And it's time to ruin this driver's happy meal. A marked unit blocks her escape route at the front while Dunk slams the back door.
It's a stop, Leeds Road.
These are a couple of dinner guests the driver wasn't expecting. Another officer has the driver in hand and quickly has a confession.
Have you got a drink?
While the driver prepares for a breath test, Duncan deals with the passenger. He's done nothing wrong and is keen to get home.
Just stay in the vehicle. It's for your safety. You're on a main road at the moment as well.
I'm getting...
Just stay where you are for a second.
No, I'm getting out.
Until we can establish everything
out.
That's gone on.
And out.
You're on a main road. You've had a lot to drink. Okay. I'm just asking you to stay there for your safety at the moment.
I'm getting out.
The man is becoming agitated and Duncan is concerned for his well-being.
OK, as soon as we've checked you out and everything's in order, if everything is in order, then you can go on your way.
No, I want to get out of the car.
Just
2 seconds.
Just while we check you out.
So, can I get out? Excuse me.
Just 2 seconds. 2 seconds.
Stop forcing me back in.
Before the situation escalates, his details come in.
120, thanks very much. Right, the details will come back. I'm happy that you say who you are.
Thank you very much.
Checking people's information is normal procedure, but the man isn't best pleased about being delayed.
We're just checking that you were who you said you were. Okay?
No, I am. And
we didn't know that. We didn't know that. Not everybody tells us the truth, funnily enough.
Some people might be wanted to see.
This is what we have to establish, okay?
So, you're a joke, mate.
Right. Well, I'm happy that you are who you say you are now, so thanks very much for your time.
The man takes his box of Stella and hits the road, as the driver has blown 97. That's almost three times the legal limit, which means she's off to the nick to blow on the evidential breath test machine. But the passenger won't go gently into the night.
You like this sort of stuff? Doing this?
You're a prick, man! What a dick!
The main thing is there's a drink driver off the road. But it's been a tricky encounter for Dunk.
It's quite often the fact that we have to deal with other people who are trying to interfere as opposed to just dealing with the person that, you know, we want to, the suspect, and he just makes it more and more awkward for us. She's gone to the cell, she's going to be in there for the night. We won't release her until she's blown under the legal limit because we can't risk that she might not drive again.
The girl was disqualified for 20 months and fined £249. No further action was taken against the passenger. Interceptors often work in pairs, and when you find the right partner, it's a marriage made in heaven.
How long have we been together for?
Well, we're at District together.
So, 4 years pretty much worked together.
Yeah.
Had a month apart.
Pretty cool.
Hard work.
I know. We're nearly brokers, didn't it?
It did, it tested us.
Chris H is fond of a kebab and the camaraderie with his colleagues. And he's more than happy to be sat next to his namesake tonight.
It's good though, isn't it? It's nice. We worked well at District together, we had a good laugh and we got results, and really lucky to have the same team on road to policing as well.
Chris B is partial to a prawn cocktail crisp and a minty aero, but you'll never find him dropping his empty wrappers on the street. Unlike the passenger in the Ford Focus in front.
As we were going, I was letting to watch traffic lights, this car's just come past us and turned off. And passengers just lobbed juice thing from KFC, I think it was.
Littering is an offence that can get you a £150 fine. Not only that, it's rude.
I thought it would go in then.
Time to clean up the streets.
Hello. Is this your car?
Yeah, it is.
Can't come pull me? Because first of all, we can do, if we want to do, we can check any documents on any car that we want to do, but your mate threw some attic car onto the floor, some rubbish.
Who?
Him. So it drew attention to us, that's why.
Throwing rubbish from a car is almost asking to be pulled over. And once stopped, an interceptor is duty-bound to check all is in order.
Have you got your driving licence?
I ain't got no driving licence, mate. I just passed my test recently.
How recently?
Recently, like two, three weeks ago.
Jump in back of our car and we'll do some checks in there. Come round here.
While Chris H deals with the aggrieved driver.
You're creeping up on me.
Who is?
You lot, just creeping up on me. I got pulled today, actually.
Just take a seat back of there.
Chris B lays down the law to the little out.
Just don't dump your rubbish on the street, all right? We saw, I think it's like a KFC cup or something like that. Just put it in bin.
And then takes a look at the car.
Well, that's not good.
The rear tyre is deflated, which could be 3 points on the driver's brand new licence. But he's more worried about the injustice of being pulled for his mate's littering.
But at least guy threw something. I haven't even seen him.
Right, but we have. So we've stopped you. We can stop any...
Do you know what I mean? I don't understand.
Because you're... what am I going to do? Run next to the car and have a chat with him? Don't be stupid.
Speak to him then, innit?
We have, we told him.
Let me speak to him then, innit?
Why are you getting annoyed because you've been stopped? You've got to remember, you've just passed your test, yeah?
Blood, they're trying to get onto me because you dashed it in, apparently. Blood.
What are friends for?
Are we listening or what?
What kind of shit?
No,
if we don't listen, you're going to get a ticket.
Trying to harass, man.
The poor harassed driver isn't impressing the Chris's.
But yeah, look, officer, yeah, obviously, I don't know what I've done wrong here, obviously.
I've just been trying to explain it to you, but you've got more interest in speaking to your mate out there.
Obviously, I'm just telling
and playing up in front of the camera.
Anyways, ain't you? You're going to speak to him anyways, isn't it? So I might as well...
I've already spoke to him.
What do you think, Chris?
Take your time, Chris. Have a good think.
That's what I think.
I love her.
Officer, listen.
The vehicle's not taxed.
The vehicle's not taxed?
Nope.
No.
It's not... Sure it's not. But yeah, we just checked. It's not been taxed since July.
It's not being taxed. Nah, that can't be right.
Oh, yes, it can. And brace yourself, Mr. Grumpy.
So, because that's 2 months and a day out of tax, the DVLA want us to seize cars and take them off at road.
Are you being serious?
I'm being 100% serious.
Nah, you can't do office.
Well, we can and we are.
What if my listen, because the car was meant to be taxed, yeah?
The car?
Sorted.
Yeah, but you've not even checked it. Because you don't know. Because you're a new driver, that's what you've told me.
It's estimated around 2% of the licensed vehicles on UK roads don't have tax. That's over 700,000.
The DVLA will want you to pay a deposit towards tax in the car and then you can go get it back tomorrow morning.
While the lad's car is being seized, they let him off the points for the tyre. but he's still feeling hard done by.
I feel like you lot are just, I don't know, just trying to get onto me, eh?
Listen. No, listen. Because we're going down the wrong route now. If I were going to get onto you, I'd do you 3 points for tyre. So I think just doing you for the tax offence is being pretty lenient, don't you?
That shut him up, which concludes our business for this evening.
No, you can get out. We're done. Good. Some people deal with people differently. I tend to like to see how people are going to speak to me to start with. You know, as a new driver, he should have been sat there, head in his hands, thinking, what have I done here? You know, I've been stupid, but he wasn't really like that, was he? It was the attitude of, I've got my mates in the car, why have you stopped me? I'm going to play up, and it's, well, ultimately, you've walked home now.
The car is recovered.
Nice one, see you later.
And Team Chris performs one last public service further down the road.
There's a bin right there. How hard were that?
No further action was taken against the little out, but the driver was reported for no tax and his vehicle was seized. Still to come. A death trap on wheels, one careless owner, dodgy MOT.
How does that drive?
Can't wait to get out.
Ambulance now, please.
Today's cars are safer than ever.
This airbag here has been deployed from the roof. That's probably what saved his life, to be fair.
But only if things like airbags, handbrakes...
I've just pulled it up another four ratchets there.
...and suspension...
Sorry.
...are in good repair. And Claire and Nick are after a hatchback that's anything but.
I mean, it's been written off. And it's not been repaired particularly well.
The car, a 150-mile-per-hour Golf R, was inspected 3 weeks ago and deemed a death trap.
The vehicle had no airbags in it. It had hundreds of faults on it. And the engine, they thought, was stolen, but we couldn't prove it. So, in essence, we had to give it back. However, the DVSA prohibited it with a PG9.
A PG9 forbids a car going on the road until it passes a new MOT.
And loads of work needed doing to it.
But miraculously, 24 hours after the owner got his death trap back, the Vehicle Operating Services Agency reports that it passed its MOT with flying colours.
There were a lot of work required on this car for it to pass an MOT, so for it to be done in that time, to get the parts, to get the work done and to pass an MOT, it's not true.
Nick suspects a bent garage issued the MOT for cash without seeing the vehicle.
Can just hand him over to us and...
Yep. And while Claire deals with the driver...
Get in, jump take a seat in front of you.
Oh, that's fine.
But... Jump in, then I can just pull in this space, I'm not blocking Alt Road.
He inspects the freshly MOT Golf to see if it really is roadworthy.
It's as we were, you know, these seat belts aren't working, airbag lights, so they've changed the tyres. So it's not past its MOT as it should have done.
It's a wreck, but the driver isn't getting nicked.
We're not looking at offences for this particular person. It's about getting this car off the road.
It's an accident waiting to happen, this car. So it's a good job tonight that we've got it off the roads again.
Nick drives the accident waiting to happen to the police recovery garage, carefully.
Nick's a mechanic, basically, so it'll be good for him to drive it so he can see what it feels like. And because when Bobo drove it the other week, he said it felt like the front of the car were attached to the car.
For anyone not mechanically minded, that isn't good.
It was an insurance write-off. They've obviously bought it and put it back together with like a jigsaw puzzle from different cars. How does that drive?
Can't wait to get out.
Inside, they go to work with police mechanics.
That's an MOT failure,
that. Yeah. It's only sample.
Should have had one yesterday.
Yeah, that's an MOT failure. Excessively leaking. It's not.
Look at this.
That's a failure.
Yeah, there's no airbags in it.
That's a failure.
I know. I suppose it's a different element to our job. It's not just about, you know, catching criminals doing burglaries or whatever. It's about making roads safer, and it's definitely making the roads safer not having this on it tonight. That's for sure.
Claire breaks out the list of faults from the last time it was inspected.
Brake pad excessively worn, offside axle 2.
That's literally metal to metal.
Yeah, so that's not been fixed. Both back brake pads are literally metal on metal. You've no brake pads on your on the back, so you're not going to stop. Airbag obviously missing when fitted. Seatbelt retraction mechanism doesn't release. We know that that's still not right. Wheel stood missing, one of the total for that wheel near side axle 2. So that's you at back on that side.
Shocking.
This is one of the worst cars they've ever seen pass an MOT.
Missing.
It's got no wheel missing. If it wasn't that dangerous, I'd be
has
laughing.
Has that been done?
Wheel nuts are missing on 3 out of 4 wheels.
You've got bolts missing out of your wheel that secure your wheel to your car. So why would you want to drive around when you haven't got your wheel secured to your car properly? The MOT was done yesterday.
I don't think this car's been in the garage. I think it's a phone call. OK, mate, there you go. And there's 100 quid up waiting to you.
It shouldn't be on the road. It's not fit to be on the road. I drove it. It's not safe to be on the road.
The owner of the knackered Golf awaits his day in court. The dodgy garage is now under investigation by the DVSA, and the mechanic who issued the MOT has been struck off.
The Interceptors are back new next Wednesday at 8. A new type of mobile security is patrolling our streets. Meet the bouncers working 24/7, new Monday at 10. And tonight, illegal clothing and drug dealers are under surveillance as the police raids team come knocking in Caught by Surprise. New next.
Thank you.